Hey everybody, it's CrimsonBlade17 here, and welcome back to more Neopets the Darkest Fairy. When last we left off, we cleared out the clogs in the sewers like Master Torak asked of us, and then we went back, we learned about the power of motes and what they can do from him. And now we've been sent to go talk to the King's Chamberlain, Lazlo, for our next quest. Who could all chores? He's on the second floor. Alright, so we gotta go up to the top. We get to see the king, maybe. You'll see where he sleeps, so maybe that's something. Alright, where's King's Chamber? God damn it, camera! King's personal library, maybe? Does he have one? Ooh, I see something over here. Let me in! Please don't interrupt the players, sir. Oh, they're playing poker. Ah, books! I like books. Let me read the books. Hey, who are you? Lord Adelhead. I hope someone gets rid of this friendly filthy bird soon. Birds! Brightville now. Long have Brightville and Meridale been connected now more than ever with two brothers on the same thrones, or on different thrones. Skarl has always been more commanding, though Hagen is considered the wisest. So, Skarl, the King of Meridale, is a bit more militaristic, and Hagen is a bit more of a wise man. No, I don't want to read that book. Get the fuck out of my way, King. King Skarl the First. King Skarl is the present king in a long line of noble kind, unassuming, genteel, and brave Skeeth rulers. For years, King Skarl has ruled the realm of Meridale with grace and power unseen in lesser realms. It is expected, thanks to Skarl, that he will reign for many, many years more. All hail great Skarl the First! Alright, so this is when the king looks like he was reading. Crimes, Volume 3, Secrets of Meridale. The king's guard was shocked. To the best of their knowledge, Valorgard was an outstanding knight. Despite the accusations of king's advisors, Sir Valorgard had no obvious reason to steal from his lord, but evidence soon surfaced as they caught the light leaving the treasury with no explanation as to how he got in. After Valorgard was caught, security around the royal treasury increased dramatically. The Royal Guard checked with Lenny Architects about a rumored secret passage, however the architects would neither confirm nor deny its existence. Illicent, Guardian of the Glade. Illicent, the Earth Fairy, looked over the transformed Wereloop King and sighed. Go home, little Thoggle Fox, she whispered, and you'll be back to yourself soon. Illicent had come to Meridale for a little peace and quiet. She didn't know worse dangers were yet to come. Foreshadowing. Fairy Queen. Queen of the Fairies and ruler of Fairyland, Fiora has been in charge for as long as any can remember. She rarely descends from her home in the topmost tower of Fairyland, preferring instead to listen to petitioners in the council chambers. But when she does come among the people, it's usually to reward acts of great bravery. Alright, last book. Read the book. The Citadel Wars. And from the Dark Citadel came Lord Darrigan. The defenders of Meridale rose up, and they drove him from his evil ways. Though Darrigan found peace and goodness, his Lieutenant Cass took out the cause of darkness. He was narrowly defeated. Any other books? Nope. Okay. Wait, is there one on the shelf? No. Okay, so we're done reading the books. Some of you probably hate that, but I love the backstory. That's King Chambers a bit. Alright, let's go talk to this last little prick. Is that a book? No, that's a bar. They've got a bar. This king's got it all. Thank goodness, Mr. Torak finally sent somebody. The king's been trying to take nap for hours. And do you hear that racket from outside? Hmm. It's the Crocobex come to roost in the courtyard castle courtyard again. If the king doesn't get his nap soon, he'll be in a mood. And when he's in a mood, heads have the tendency to roll. I need you to get rid of any Crocobex nests you find in the courtyard. Hmm. Find the Crocobex roosts and smash them to pieces. Got it? And please hurry. If the king doesn't get his nap soon, he'll turn cranky. Very cranky. You know, I would, if it wasn't for the fact that it's required for the story, I would let him get cranky just to see him cut off this bastard's head. He needs to learn to be nicer to people. But that's neither here nor there. Time to GTFO out of this castle and go kill some Crocobex. The birds, the evil birds. Anybody who's seen the movie Birds knows what I'm talking about. I haven't seen it, but yeah. It's a movie about birds. Birds are evil. Birds. Damn the birds. Alright, if I remember right, this is actually very easy. They actually mark where they all are in your map for you. And
they're all fairly simple to get to. Sorry.
Alright, remember the first one of the first is over here. Hey look, the castle crops and spin to win! Spin to win. I am destroying all of your crops. How do you like me now? Wait. Up and over. Here we go, Mr. Snail. Hey, Turtum. We've heard about these. One of the kids back home would get them to hide in their shells by hitting them with a stick. Sword. After a second, they would pop back out. I wonder if you can help me reach the awakening place up top. Right. On top of him. And fly. Up. Come on, up. There's the first nest. Now, obviously, you have to kill the bird defending its nest. Because now we're killing birds and we're killing their babies in the nest because, you know, eggs and all that. Ow! Oh, he's got a jumpy! He's got a jumpy! Give me your jumpy! Hold on. Oh, okay. I thought I was gonna sneeze. I still might. Why do I have that on my armor? Don't want to be wasting motes like that. That's one crocodile nest down. Still have four more to find. Fine, bitch, I know where they all are. And I know how to get to most of them, too. Next one's over there by the platforms. Remember, right, this is the one where crazy camera angles will kill you. What these guys are doing here, I don't know. I don't see like a hole or the castle anywhere, but apparently they think it needs fixing. Hey, bro. Apologies, Squire. It's just we can't work with the crocodiles about. They might peck us or something. You lazy prick! I bet you I could reach those vines and use them to get across this gap. I just need to jump to reach them. Jump! Damn it. Jump too early. You hear that? Birds. Oh, crap. That bird's gonna knock me down. Two nests are gone. I'm making progress. Only three are left. This game loves the number 5. Can I cut these? I cannot cut these. Okay. So no money and no nothing for me. Damn this game. Damn it. Alright. Next one. Up there. That's probably off tune because the way I'm having to play, listen to this. And unfortunately, I can't hook the headset up to my TV. It's made for Xbox only. Unfortunately, Xbox and PC. So I can't hook it up to my PC, or my TV, but, you know, when I get some money. I'm getting my car Wednesday, so I won't have any money for a while. That's costing me 11 goddamn grand. But, bad bird. Well, it's costing me money. It's a good car. It's a used Chevy Cobalt. Red 2009 Chevy Cobalt LT. It's red, two-door, and it's... Damn it. Oh, I keep feeling like I'm gonna sneeze. It's only got 35,000 miles on it, which is very good for a used car. And I'm looking forward to it.
Damn it, why is my foot itching?
Down we go. I'm just hoping I can get it, because it's been put off for 2 weeks now. When we first gonna buy it, the tire pressure light came on it, they said. They went, put it on the computer, had it checked out. There were a couple things wrong with it. They had it sent to a Chevy place to have it fixed. Now they had to order parts for it to fix that problem. So that's going to take a couple. That'll take until Wednesday, and today is Saturday. Actually, for you, today would be. Let's see if I upload one tonight, one tomorrow. So that would be. This would be going up Monday night, I believe. So. Ha! That crocodile's down! Is he coming back up? No, he's not. Oh, there he is. Back to the wall, back to the wall. Quick, he's distracted. Alright, four nests destroyed. One left. Wait. Where's the damn bird? Oh, there it is. Alright, last nest is right over there. I don't know just how to get to it. This isn't nearly as annoying as I thought it was. Again, as a kid, everything seems hard. Whoa, bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. I didn't have to know I could have bounced like that. Slash, slash, slash. That was the last one. Those crocobecks won't be coming back around here again. Now to tell Chamberlain and Laszlo in the upper hall. Okay. So let's go tell Dumbass, and we'll hopefully be done with running errands for him. I don't like him. I don't like anybody who thinks they're just because they're rich doesn't mean that. Just because you're rich doesn't mean you're the best. I'm just guessing is what I'm trying to say. Just because you're rich does not make you better than everybody else. That's what pisses me off sometimes. Just because you're rich, you think you can be a snob. Nope! Guess what, bitch? You're still a person. That was a close call. Good job, Squire. The king is now slumbering peacefully. I'll mention your good work to Master Torak. Report back to him. Damn it! Quit giving me the runaround. Damn it, I did not mean to eat that. Spam the button. Give you all a headache from this. Okay, I'll quit. That is slightly annoying. Because even though it annoys you guys, it annoys me too. I can't break the chairs. Okay.
Just wanted some extra money, man.
I can sleep. Well, I need to sleep right now, but you know what? Is all good? Okay. Master Torak, where are you, good sir? You're in the pit. Why are you in the pit, bro? Yeah, bro. Why are you doing in the pit? Huh? Bro. Poflowski. Still alive, huh? We'll soon fix that. It's time to learn about shields. Any bumpkins can stand behind them to block attacks, but only true warriors utilize the powers of motes to strengthen their defense. The best warrior can even use motes to deflect missile shots back right back at their attacker. Now, let's begin. Now, attach your fire mote to your shield the same way you did with the sword. Mm. Two things you must always remember about motes. Opposites alignments increase damage, and similar alignments repel damage. Mm. So, for your strike, for your sake, you better make sure you assign a fire line mote to your shield. Alright, good sir. Oh wait, I can just... Oh! Sweet. No, wait. Alright, now go stand in that ring over there. Yes, that charred spot on the ground. As a precaution, you may want to assign a mote to your armor as well. Motes in your war armor reduce damage from attacks with a similar alignment. Now, stand in the ring and block the shots coming from that tower. Oh! Did I do it? Am I doing it? Got it. Not bad, Squire. Not bad at all for the first day. Now go to the barracks and get some sleep. There'll be more for you to do tomorrow. Right, let's go ahead and take that off my shield. I don't want to waste it. And we get to go to sleep. Yay, sleepy time. Sleepy time tea. So you would actually drink that stuff? I do. It's fantastic. We're going to sleep, and then we're going to end the video, because we're getting a little into the time limit here. We're getting close to it. We're getting close to the 15-minute mark. And I want to end the video. Sleepy time! Tor, wake up! You've been called for a mission. Master Torak wants to see you in the hall right now. He's in the main hall. King of Redundancy, I am. Why I couldn't say that correctly, I don't know. It's like I'm gonna...
Maybe it's because I'm trying to talk. Damn it.
Maybe it's because I tried to talk too fast. Torak, where the hell are you? Supposedly behind me. Oh, you are behind me. Sir, what's the mission? Your armor's shiny. Tor, good. Hope you're well rested. By order of the king, you have been assigned a royal mission. A mission? Smile. The castle has received word of Ixi raiders attacking a small mining village in the southern mountains named Cogham. Hey, I read about that. You've been chosen to join Sir Harlag to give them aid. Understood? Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Then find Sir Harlag. He should be in the dining hall. Tell him your orders and ride for Cogham. I get a horse? Yeah, I get a horse. Now, go! And this is where we will end this video. As always, thanks for watching.